No.
Okay.
Everyone remembers Anderson Silva for the great athlete he was, but he was also a bit of a clown and loved to have fun.
Agora a gente vai comer, pô.
But it translated to results for him inside the octagon.
Anderson Silva right now is as close as there is to an unbeatable fighter.
He's such a sniper. His strikes are so accurate, so deadly. The man literally has every single skill that you need to be a fighter. It's a treat to watch that guy perform.
Welcome to the octagon, Anderson Silva. Oh, God, he was right.
He's also just as equally remembered for this, but a lot of people tend to throw the baby out with the bathwater and forget the great things that were done when people were in their prime, and one mistake doesn't define a career.
Eu gosto do que eu faço. Eu amo o que eu faço. Eu cresci ouvindo o som de Michael Jackson, eu cresci vendo James Brown, vendo atletas como Muhammad Ali, Michael Jordan.
Sucker, you ain't nothing. As Anderson mentioned, dancing had a big impact on his career and his training. He was often seen dancing on his way to fighting, before fights, while he was in the ring, after fights, after he'd won, and oftentimes during training. And as a side note, dancing is one of the best warm-ups you can do because it refines and warms up, as well as primes, every system that you could think of utilizing during any competition. Dancing warms you up on all levels, so it's a great performance benefit. And the play didn't stop for him outside the ring. He would bring it in the middle of the fights as well. And what play does is it keeps you loose, keeps you stress-free, but it also keeps you finely tuned, so that way you can adapt to and survive and thrive amidst whatever your opponent's throwing at you. It made it fun for you, it made it demoralizing for your opponent, it made it so that their timing would be throw off. It could be just a fantastic tool for you to utilize while in the midst of competition, because a lot of people don't know what to expect when you're doing these things. And you could be serious or you could be playing around. They don't really know, so it throws their game off. The thing about play as well is that it's healing, and it also is stress relieving, because being in the midst of the fight game is a highly stressful and anxious environment to be in, so this would keep you nice and loose, you know, playful and free. We know him as Anderson the Spider Silva. And he was the spider because he used all 8 of his limbs. So he used his hands to get the job done, right? 2 hands, that's 2. He would utilize his elbows. 2 elbows, 2 and 2, that's 4. Boom! He would use his knees. 2 and 2 and 2, that's 6. And lastly, he would use his feet. 2 and 2 and 2, that's 8. He would utilize all 8 striking platforms to get the job done, just like a spider. And much like the spider, he would also utilize trickery, because you don't want to go by the rules fully when you're in a competition setting. People go by the rules to make themselves feel safe, feel like they're doing things right, but a lot of people who really succeed are the ones that break the rules, make their own, and mess around with other people who use rules. Let's break down this sequence of Anderson Silva and his timing and trickery. He would use his motion and his play and his evasiveness to get out of the way, which would open up his opponent to strike them with relative ease. And the thing is, when you're hitting someone like that after they're done throwing, they're not ready for the strike that you're about to throw back. And it's going to be more powerful and oftentimes knock someone down, not because it's super powerful, but because it catches them off guard and they're not prepared for it. So it can be a really light strike that puts them down. Just like the spider, it's sneaky, but it's highly effective. Now enjoy some of Anderson Silva's career highlights, where you see the play, the power, the creativity, the fun, just the freestyle fighting prowess that he exuded throughout his fighting career.